Well, if you've been seeing a lot of fun trends in the fashion magazines this fall, but can't see yourself spending the money, well, you're not alone. And we have some great ideas for you. Meaghan actually has some great DIY ideas that are going to spruce up your wardrobe without breaking the bank. That's the most important part.
It really is.
I want to start off with something that everyone's taking out right now is sweaters.
I know, it's true, Michaela, and like jersey shirts. So first and foremost, I am one who will never tell you to give up a really awesome shirt at a store. So this is something I got at Macy's and it's bedazzled. So it kind of works as inspiration to everything else that you want to do. And you can use anything that's in your closet already and just refresh it and repurpose it. So like you were saying before, knits, exactly. That's what people are bringing out right now. And a great way to refresh it and use things that are already at home is to create almost like a bib necklace. And you would just sew this on here after you create a mold from felt and fabric.
Yeah, let's see that finished piece.
Yeah, normally it would be on here, but for this, it's pretty delicate and you kind of want a knit that's heavy. So, and I also created all these little jewels. Like I created this bug. Bugs and beetles are really stylish right now
with
the fall
fashion.
What did you
take? Maybe just leftover buttons?
Exactly. You can use leftover buttons. This was from a shoe that I had that was old. Gems and stones that were from necklaces that I don't wear anymore. Bracelets that maybe I wore when I was like in junior high. Just random things that you might have at home. And then also you can go to your local craft store.
Something so you made that bib?
Yeah, super easy, and you always see in the stores right now are these really pyramid kind of looking items. And
rocker-esque.
It is rocker-esque, and heavy metal, like you were just saying, heavy metal is a huge trend for fall 2013, so this is a great way to update it, and you don't have to spend a lot of money on that shirt that they've already bedazzled. So
I like that.
And like I said, if you want to treat yourself to something nice, do it. And then this is something that I thought was really interesting, was updating your shoes. So these were shoes that I was like, I'm not going to use them anymore because they're kind of scuffed.
Right.
But I put a spin onto it. So I used glitter glue.
Okay.
And I used this little mechanism here to kind of sponge it on.
So cheap. You can always find those at craft stores.
Exactly. So I took these really great shoes from Zara that I'm not going to wear anymore. And then I pressed in the glitter glue to make some texture. So I globbed it all on. And that's how I made it kind of look stylish.
And it looks like a fun new pair of shoes without having to spend the money. Now, handbags too, every lady wears those.
Exactly. So something that I did here was I looked in an Anthropology catalog, loved this image, and I literally Mod Podged it on here. So Mod Podge is a glue that's very clear. So I just, again, used one of these little things and I Mod Podged it on there. Then this was, I think this was just this old like pocketbook that I had in it. It was yarn inside. So I put felt on top and then I used paper that you can find at craft stores. And leopard is a huge trend for fall 2013.
Look at
that. Also, this little doodad, instead of having the little leather piece that they had, I just grabbed that from an old jewelry piece that I had.
Freshen it up.
Yeah.
Last but not least, a belt.
Last but not least, a belt. Everybody has a ton of these in their wardrobe.
Or they're your best friends sometimes.
Sometimes you buy dresses and they have the skinny belts too. So what I did was I did a quick glue on here and I thought you could take this foil, which is gold. Gold foil is something I love. You should definitely have this in your closet, your craft little container that you have at home. And you use Mod Podge to put it on top. So you want to take the foil actually off the paper.
Oh, okay. This is two different
layers. And you can place it little by little onto.
Can I even take it off the paper?
Don't ruin your nails. Those are really cool.
Okay.
So it's a little bit difficult to put it on.
Here.
let's see. So you take this off. All right. So let's try this way. DIY 101. So you just kind of Mod Podge it on here so then you can create this like gold belt. And the reason why I put this gold, these two gold pieces on here first was because it's not like you're going to be able to get the gold all around. So to have the brown kind of around here picks up the gold right in the middle.
I still can't get this gold.
It can be a little tricky.
We're going to improv.
Clearly.
That's what happens when you DIY. You just have to go with the flow.
All right. So we're just going to get this gold on here and then you can keep the belt after. All right. We'll have to do this after the show.
Hey, very cool.
But it's coming out.
We'll continue working on that and we'll make sure that we show you the finished product. But those are great ideas.
Yeah.
Because you have old clothes,
you want new ones, but you don't have the money to do so.
Now you're turning them into
exactly. Buy a piece that you love if you love it at the store, but also you can use the items that you already have in your closet and take the items that maybe you're not using anymore from your jewelry boxes.
I like that. I got a bunch of extra things. I'll start working on some of my own. If you missed any of these tips, don't you worry. We're going to post them all on our website. Just go to WPRI.com and click on the Rhode Show.